Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1310, Filter Dropdown. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in by Bob. Bob sent me this spreadsheet, and it actually looked like this. Okay, so there were these filter dropdowns, and Bob was going to a specific product out here, choosing that product. And he wanted to see the totals in row 2. So let's go turn this off and take a look at what's going on here. The real headings for this data set are in row 3, product and the months going across. Here they have a subtotal function that's subtotaling everything beneath it. The advantage of subtotal is that it shows only the visible cells. So if we were able to filter just product A, that would give us the totals. And then they had some sort of a percentage up here. Now, when they turn on the auto filter here, and you choose a single cell, and it looks for the entire contiguous range. So that's control asterisk shows you that contiguous range. And then it uses the top row for the dropdowns. Well, that's not really what we want to have happen. I said, Bob, the solution here is really, really simple. I want you to go between row 2 and row 3 and insert a row. All right. And if you want, you can even make that row incredibly small, like a row height of 1 or something like that, so no one even realizes it's there. Then go into your data set and turn on the filter dropdowns, and now you see the filters up here in, well, row 4, where the real headings are. And now you can go through and choose just one product, A, and get the totals for that product line, which I think is what he was trying to do. Now, hey, by the way, if you have to set this up, Bob didn't tell me how he did this. One great way of doing it is to filter the data set first and then come down below and hit the AutoSum button. And usually AutoSum gives us sum functions, but this one, because we've already filtered the data set, gives us the subtotal function, and then you can control X to copy that and control V to paste, creating a ad hoc subtotal at the top. Now when I pasted that, the formulas that we're referring there, of course, became bad, but great little trick for setting that up beforehand. So the answer in this case is just incredibly simple. We'll just create a tiny little row, a blank row, to keep the real headings away from the calculations above the table, and then the auto filters allowed to go to row 4 instead of row 1. Listen to me still calling an auto filter what they call it, just a filter now for 4 years going on. But I still call it the auto filter because that's what it was called. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.